was 1944 and the war was almost over when my mum met a Maori soldier at a military dance in Dover. Well, he winked and she blinked, quite taken by his swarthy looks, his style. And then he stepped up and he said to her partner, "Can I borrow her for a while?" Well, by 1945, Dad said to Mum, "I think we should get wed." And Mum said, "Yeah, that'd be really nice." So they spoke to her father, her parents, well, her father to be precise. And he said, "Can you see the challenged boy? She's white, you're black. You'll take her to your country and she never will come back. Love, what do you know of love, boy? Come here and discuss, because you know her mother's weeping, wailing, making quite a fuss. And what about your babies? Maybe they'll be black, maybe tan. Oh, I know, let's have a whiskey, let's talk man to man." So, much to the woman's folks' dismay, the men went off to the tavern where they spent the day and shared a bond over an ale or two and breathed a sigh of relief at what to do. "Look here, is there no turning back, I fear? Her mother is in tears, she's devastated, she's embarrassed. What will the neighbours think? And what about your family in New Zealand? Won't this cause a stink? Not to mention my fears about racial discrimination. You better talk to the captain of your station." Well, the captain said it was all right, and there was a church in the town. And Dad and his friend Ned, who'd been hanging around, consulted the padre. And the padre said, "Hurry up, nuptials at 2. And Mum said, "Oh, I've got no, I haven't a bridesmaid." And Ned said, "Well, I do." And then Mum said, "Well, I haven't any flowers." And he smiled and laughed. He slaughtered that too. He stole a posy of flowers off a graveside as they were going up the path. And there, in a manner befitting his station, dressed in his uniform, looking ever so grand, with my mum on his arm and his cap in his hand, they wed. Well, if I said the path for the pair was plain sailing, I'd be telling a big fat lie. Because when Dad got home to New Zealand and his spirits were high, the wrath of his family came down with all its might. "Dear God, he's married a white!" So it took quite a while for them to get used to my mother's white face, and she had to endure society's obvious distaste. But love endured despite of all that, because love does not discriminate between white or black.
"Mother, may I go out to swim? Yes, my dark-eyed daughter. Mother, when I go out to swim at the pool, I can't get in because of the colour of my skin, because I'm your daughter. Daughter, mother, may I go to the show? Yes, my dark-eyed daughter. Mother, tell me, do you know which side of the theater I should go? Go where the colour of your skin won't show, my darling dark-eyed daughter. Mother, will I go to school? Yes, my dark-eyed daughter. Mother, when I go to school, Children follow their parents' rule, my darling dark-eyed daughter. Mother, will I go to work? Yes, my dark-eyed daughter. You will go to work one day, but only get half of your pay. The other half will go the way of somebody's dark-eyed daughter. When will all this end? I don't know, my daughter. Maybe it will end the day when heaven and earth shall pass away. And we will hear a great voice say, you're welcome here, my daughter. Great voice say, you're welcome here.